wondering what we're doing, we are in front of a campfire and we got wonderful music behind us, and we are doing our introductory video for Campfire Revival here at Surrey Hills Farm. So I'll go into more detail about that in just a few. But right now we're just going to listen to some worship music. First, I want to start by reading out of Psalms. So it's out of Psalms 2. I read through the Amplified Bible. Why are the nations... It's okay. Why are the nations in an uproar, in turmoil against God? And why do the people devise a vain and hopeless plot? The kings of the earth take their stand, and the rulers take counsel together against the Lord and his anointed, the Messiah, the Christ, saying, let us break apart their divine bands of restraint and cast away their cords of control from us. He who sits enthroned in the heavens laughs at their rebellion. The sovereign Lord scoffs at them, and in supreme contempt he mocks them. Then he will speak to them in his profound anger, terrifying them with his displeasure, saying, yet as for me, I have anointed and firmly installed my king upon Zion, my holy mountain. I will declare the decree of the Lord. And he said to me, you are my son. This day I proclaim I have begotten you. Ask of me, and I will assuredly give you the nations of your inheritance. At the ends of the earth as your possession, you shall break them with a rod of iron, and you shall shatter them in pieces like earthenware. This was also found in Revelations 12:5 and 19:5. Now therefore, O kings, act wisely. Be instructed and take warning, O leaders, judges, and rulers of the earth. Worship the Lord and serve him with reverence, with awe-inspired fear and submissive wonder. Rejoice, yet do so with trembling. Kiss, pay respect to the Son, so that he does not become angry and you perish in the way of his wrath, may soon be kindled and set aflame. How blessed, fortunate, prosperous, and favored by God are all those who take refuge in him. We have chosen as two families to take refuge in our Lord. We have chosen to allow our lives to be completely 100% under the authority of God. We have made the commitment that in any area we devote everything and putting God first. In our work, in what we do here, in our friendship, in our raising of our children, everything we do is devoted to him. And that is why he has brought us here. And not only that, he has asked us to allow our lives to be a representation of him. What we do on a daily basis here, which all of you have seen for, 3 years now, we do in honor of God. How we raise our children, to living together, to what we do on the farm, to having customers come. Anybody who comes here knows that this land belongs to God, and we are here doing his work for him, bringing his kingdom here on earth, from heaven on earth. God is asking this nation to do the exact same thing. And Kirk Cameron last year, at the beginning of, right, was the beginning of this year? Was when?
Yeah.
Yes, the beginning of this year, did a 100-day revival. And me and Melanie devotedly watched this every single time he did it. And he is now reigniting this, but not just himself doing it from his yard, but he is equipping everybody who is willing, like us, to do the same exact thing. So he has created amazing material out of the American Covenant, and what he has taught, which is basic moral, biblical standards that every Christian should be following regardless, and how our country, the United States of America, was founded on God. That through our forefathers, he has allowed us to have the freedom that we currently have. And if we will humble ourselves, turn from our wicked ways, repent of our sins, then he will heal our land again. And that is speaking to the church. He is speaking to those who have been called. And that we are supposed to be that light into the darkness. And so this is there's nine lessons, and we will be posting when we will be doing this. And along with us doing these revivals with the campfire, we're also going to have other people joining us. So if this is something that you are interested in and coming and being a part, that's what we want. We want this to be that we're just not sitting here sharing stuff over video. We want to invite people to be a part of sitting around with us as we talk about God and talk about his sovereignty and talk about how he is impacting our lives so we can encourage each other. It is very, very important in this time that people are starting to come together and unite under the body of Christ in Jesus' name. And then giving ourselves the strength to stand under his authority to go out and do what he has asked us to do in our nation. We're not just supposed to sit at home behind our doors and not speak out and not be a voice. We have chosen to be a voice to our children. We have chosen to be a voice to our community. We have chosen to be a voice to what we do moving forward in the future. We want everybody to know that who we are and what we do and why we do it is because of God. And so we want to share that with everybody, and we want to invite everybody to come and be a part of that as well with us. So this is just the intro to that, just so you can kind of see that this is what it'll look like. The kids will be playing music, we'll sit around a campfire, we'll have devotion, we'll talk about the lesson. Yes, we will do it live for those who are not able to make it, but we want everybody to come and be a part of this if you can. And maybe you just show up one time because it works in your schedule. Great. We just want to be able to share in the fellowship of who God is and what he is doing, and because it's incredible. And that's how our nation is going to be changed. That is how the beginning of our country and the colonies and the people coming together, they did life together. They made sure that their neighbor had food. They made sure that whatever they did in growing things and harvesting and making sure they got through the winter, they did it together. And I really do believe that the way our times are going, God is calling us to come back together as families. And I think that the reason that he drew us together is so that we can be an example of what that looks like. He is using us to be a light and to showing you that this works. This works greater than anything I could ever imagine. And me and Melanie share the same, we talk about this a lot, that we can't imagine doing life without each other. I cannot imagine. We're from Newport. I can't imagine still living in my wooded acres on my house and my 5 acres without doing all of this craziness to get with her. It's just incredible. And I am so grateful for what God is doing. And I cannot wait to see what God holds for us for the future. So we want to share that with you. So please come and be a part of what we're doing. And now we're going to do communion. So you're welcome to join us as we do communion. And we're going to play some more music and enjoy the campfire.
I'm going to get up and hand out communion right now, but wherever you are right now, if you're watching us live, if you're watching this in 10 hours from now, I'm going to throw my kids under the bus and make them play a song real quick while we're passing it out so that you can go to your kitchen, get yourself a cracker, some juice, whatever it is that you want, and join us for communion. So go ahead and play that song. That's what.
What?
Go ahead and play your next song.
Thank you.
So during the Passover meal, Jesus established the truth of the new covenant while they were eating the Passover. He gave new meaning to eating the bread. The unleavened bread symbolized the severing of the Israelites from the old life in Egypt. It represented a separation from worldliness, from sin, and false religion, and the beginning of a new life of holiness and godliness. So as they were eating, Jesus took the bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to them and said, "Take, eat, this is my body." The shedding of blood in a sacrifice was always God's requirement in establishing any covenant. And here, Christ's blood needed to be shed for the remission of sins. So Jesus then, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, and they all drank from it. And he said to them, "This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for many. Take the cup."
Lord, we just thank you for this day and this time. We thank you for this land, for our children, for the opportunity to live in unity with you, to walk in your will and in your ways. Lord, we thank you for your word. Thank you that when we open it, its power comes out and infiltrates every part of our life. Lord, we just thank you for the opportunity that you've laid before us. We ask your blessings over it and over each and every person that comes here to visit us or watches this online. Lord, that you would just do a good work, that we could rise up together in unity for our nation, that God right now is taking back this nation and what belongs to him. Lord, we just ask that eyes be opened and ears be hearing your word, that no one would be missing out and what you have to offer. And we thank you for this night. We thank you for communion, so that we can join with you in remembering what has been done for us through the shedding of your body and blood. And we just ask your blessings over this night.